Yo guys, what's going on? I'm the Blue Ranger, and I just got done seeing Batman vs. Superman, and I'm not much of a review person, and so that's not what this is going to be, but I wanted to talk about a certain element in that movie, mainly Doomsday. I might bring up a couple other things, but that is pretty much what I wanted to discuss, because it's a character that I've always enjoyed, and now to see him in a movie, it's worth me discussing a little bit. Right off the bat, there's going to be spoilers in this sumbitch, so if you want nothing to do with that, then you should probably head out. I honestly think that everyone should go see the movie. I did not hate it the way everyone else seems to be hating it. So, I'm not going to review it. I'm not going to give it a number. I'm not going to do anything that, but I will say that it gets the Blue Ranger, stamp of approval. I thought it was a decent movie. So I would suggest going out and seeing it for yourself. And if not, at least go Redbox it when it comes out or something. You'll probably enjoy the movie. But let's talk about Doomsday. Doomsday is a very interesting character, even though his whole point is to kill Superman. There you go. That's what happens. Let's start from this point of view. I'm not a comic book nerd. I'm a nerd in a lot of different facets. Comic books are not one of them. I know a little bit about these characters through comic book nerd friends of mine, but I was always more of an animated movie and TV show nerd. So I get my Doomsday from things like Superman Doomsday, the movie that came out, 8-9 years ago or something like that. Maybe it was less. I don't know, but it feels like a long time ago. But there was, in the TV shows and things like that where he pops up, and what my friends talked about. But essentially, the entire purpose of Doomsday's existence is to kill Superman. So if you went into this movie with any knowledge at all, you knew that Superman had to die. And one of my main gripes about this movie going in, before you know anything and you're just kind of talking off the cuff, was how can they kill Superman in what could be the beginning of a very long series of movies? Now, of course, with all of these comic book franchises, they always end up bringing the characters back in one way or another. So I'm sure that they'll figure it out. And if you've seen the movie, you know that they've already hinted that Superman's not actually dead, which is, to me that's a little bullshit. But you knew that he was going to kill Superman in one way or another. The character itself, I didn't know how it was going to fit into the movie. I was looking at it from the point of view of Batman trying to kill Superman, and vice versa. Not really understanding where the whole plot was going to go, and I didn't fully expect it to be the death of Superman / funeral for a friend, but that's where it ended up going, and the whole movie was great. I really enjoyed all of it. There was very few things that I had to complaints about, and I enjoyed Doomsday, but I really wish that I had the editing capabilities of taking Lex Luthor, who's actually Lex, like the Lex Luthor you're thinking of, it's actually his son. So if you're sitting there and thinking to yourself, well, this doesn't make sense, he's got hair, blah, 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 it's actually a different character than what you're expecting. Or at this point, you've ruined the movie for yourself. So you've probably seen it. But hopefully you gathered that it's actually Lex Luthor's son, Lex Luthor. I want to take the clip of him saying, then the devil will do it, and then just cut to Legolas turning around going, they have a cave troll. Because Doomsday looks exactly like the cave troll from, Fellowship of the Ring. Looks exactly like that character. And I was kind of like, that's a little lame. Now, after they nuke him and he absorbs some more power, he gets some of the spikes that you're used to in the visualizations and the original artist renderings of Doomsday from the comic books and the movies and stuff, but it all seems toned down. His character just seemed kind of bleh. Like, it wasn't exciting, it wasn't interesting. Doomsday is the bane of Superman. Like, I'm not talking about the character Bane, but like, he is the death of Superman, and they made him into this very just boring character in the way he was animated. I just found that his overall approach was more frightening than it was dangerous. I don't know, there was something about the fight that didn't sit right, and I haven't quite put my finger on it, so hopefully you guys can help me figure it out. There was something about him that didn't work. I did like that he shot a beam from his face and the whole thing. Like, they did a pretty decent job with it, but they came dangerously close to creating the the Hulk. I mean, let's if you've seen the Hulk movies, then you know that the way that he attacks things is very similar to the Hulk. Now, maybe that's what they were going for with this character, but it just seemed far too reminiscent to me of the Incredible Hulk. And I maybe it's because at the end of the day, they're both big hulking, like monstrous beings that use brute strength as their main form of assault. But even in a couple of the shock waves that he sends out, he doesn't do it with a clap, but it was pretty similar in the way that it was received by the environment. It was basically a giant shock wave, except Doomsday's was handled in a more electric kind of explosive way, whereas Hulk's is a sound wave thing. But the character didn't really make sense to fit into the movie as well as I think it could have been. And I'd like to try to figure out more as to why they stuck it in there. Don't be gross. But you know what I mean? You already had Wonder Woman. You already had all these little mini commercials for, the Justice League, Aquaman, The Flash, and Cyborg, and all that other stuff. You had these, like, little mini trailers for the upcoming movies, which was, it's kind of exciting. It definitely brings out some sense of excitement for those future films, which I'm sure was the point. It's basically free advertising. But you already had so much going on in this, and then Wonder Woman, who was great, just kind of shows up, and it's just like the beginning. I don't know, for some reason Doomsday just seemed plopped in there, poorly put together, poorly thought out, and he is the death of Superman. He is a huge character, he is an absolutely monstrous force within the DC universe, and he just seemed poorly done. And you'll notice, if you didn't catch what I did, is the second Doomsday shows up, the entire military is there. There was no, like, what is that? I have no idea. And then watching Superman engage it or anything, it was immediate. That thing jumped up on the top of LexCorp, and immediately the helicopters were all over. There was no explanation whatsoever. It really felt like they plopped it in there. Now, I did agree with what Angry Joe said in that they felt like they fit too many movies into one movie. That's their choice. I still thought it was a good movie. It would have been cool to see it a little bit more played out over one or two more movies. But as a whole, I thought it was good. But you get things like that where all of a sudden Doomsday is on top of this building and the entire army is just there. And I can't really explain why that's happening. So, in totality, I would have liked to see the character seem a little bit more, I don't want to say aggressive. He was pretty aggressive. But a little bit more worked into the story. He was only in the movie for 20 minutes. Maybe half an hour, killed Superman, and at the same time that he kills Superman, Superman kills him, and it's over. And it's just sort of like, this is, like, the guy. You could make an entire movie about Doomsday, which they have in the past. Superman Doomsday was an animated film, and that was the whole thing. I just feel like they kind of, I think Boogie said that they venomed him. They just sort of plopped him into the movie. There was so much great, like, I like movies that do the dialogue thing where they explain what's going on and there's a really heavy driven story. The action is fun, but I really like the lore of what's going on. And so I, whether or not they're, throwing things into buildings and just explosions and all that stuff, that's not super important to me. It's cool, but it's not what I go for. And it just seems like they had a good thing going with the movie explaining the Superman-Batman fight, and the fight between those two was super cool when he just kind of kept hitting them with the kryptonite from time to time and keeping them down. Oh, it was the best. And so I really enjoyed the fight scene and everything, and they could have turned that into the movie. It almost seemed like the movie was too long to fit Doomsday into it to kill Superman. And I really enjoy that Doomsday character, and it wasn't fleshed out as well as I would have liked it to be. Now, can you fight just a hulking creature like that for a full hour and a half? I don't know. But the action and the fight sequences and everything, and the dream sequences, goddamn, everything in this movie was really, really exciting. So I feel like they could have made it work. It was very Zack Snyder, but they did a good job. I enjoyed it, and I feel like they could have cut Doomsday into the next movie instead of fitting it into this one. I want to know what you guys think, though. Maybe I'm crazy, maybe I'm not. If you know more about comic books than I do, please educate me, because I would love to know what you think. I want to learn more. Myself and the Green Ranger, we've gotten into going to see all the movies as they come out. Usually I put them off and I might not even see them. I'm behind on Marvel films, but I'm going to catch up now because I'm really excited about all these movies coming out and I feel like I'm behind. So if you know more than I do, please educate me and help me out. But I think Doomsday is a character that could have really been fleshed out and way more interesting, and they could have used him in a more critical situation than what they did. Let me know what you think. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, and check me out at twitch.tv/OnTheBlueRanger. Seriously, go see the movie. I really liked it. And I will catch you guys next time.